Hello and welcome to A-Level Math. This is the second video in the series Geometric Progressions. I'm sorry that in the first video there was some 10 minutes from 44 minutes to 55 minutes. Due to some technical glitch, the voice was not performing good. So those questions that were covered in that video and that had that problem are also covered in this video. I'm sorry about that. So let's get started with those questions first of all. If PQR are in GP and the equations PX squared plus 2QX plus R is equal to 0 and DX squared plus 2EX plus F is equal to 0 have a common root, then show that something, something, something are in AP. Okay. So we are given that P, Q and R are in AP. So, given this, we have Q squared is equal to P times R. Because PQR are in GP, then from that we know that Q by P is equal to R by Q. So, we'll be having Q square is equal to PR. So, this is what we have. So, always remember that if three numbers are in GP, then the square of the first is equal to the product of the first and the third. So remember this thing, it is very much useful for three numbers in GP. So what we have in hand is that Q squared is equal to P times R. Now next they are saying that the equations PX squared plus 2QX plus R equal to 0 and DX squared plus 2EX plus F is equal to 0 have a common root. Okay, so let's take this PX squared plus 2X plus 2QX plus R is equal to 0. From here we have the value of x is equal to minus 2q plus minus root over 2q square minus 4 times p times r whole divided by 2p. This is from the Sridharacharya formula. So we have minus 2q plus or minus root over 4q square minus 4pr whole divided by 2p. This gives us minus 2q plus or minus root over. Now q square is equal to pr, so we can write down this as 4pr minus 4pr, and effectively it actually cancels out, so we'll be having 0 in here, and root over 0 is 0, so minus 2q plus or minus 0 divided by 2p. So the two values of x is equal to minus 2q plus 0 by 2p, which is minus 2q by 2p, and minus 2q minus 0 by 2p, which is just minus 2q by 2p. So actually x is having the same roots, so because the discriminant is 0, so you might also know this, that when the discriminant is 0, the two roots are actually equal, and this is what we are getting as well in this case. So we are getting the two roots which are actually equal. So these roots are actually minus q divided by p. So these are the two roots, minus q by p and minus q by p, of the equation px square plus 2qx plus r is equal to 0. Now they are saying that this equation and this equation have a common root. But we know that the only root of this equation is minus q by p. So that means this is also a root of this equation, because they are saying that have a common root, and because minus q by p is the only root of this equation and it has a common root, that means this minus q by p is also a root of this equation. Alright, so minus q by p is a root of this equation as well. Okay, so that means that minus q by p should satisfy this equation as well. So what we do, we just put down minus q by p in place of x. So see, what do we get? So we get d minus q by p x square plus 2 times e times minus q by p plus f is equal to 0. And we need to now show that d by p, e by q and f by r are in AP. That means we need to show that 2e by q is equal to d by p plus f by r. Remember that when three numbers are in AP, then we need to show that the sum of the first and the third term is actually equal to twice of the second term. So if we can show this, then we are done. So let's see what we have from here. We have d q squared by p squared minus 2eq by p plus f is equal to 0. So let me take 2eq on the other side. So what we have, d q squared by p squared plus f is equal to 2eq by p. But what do we need? We need, on the left hand side, we need 2e by q. So that means we have to divide by q square on the both the sides to get divide by q in here. And we need to multiply with p on both the sides. So what we actually need to do, we need to multiply with this quantity on both the sides and see what we get. So that means we'll be having d q squared by p squared times q square, sorry, p by q square, p by q square plus f into p by q square is equal to 2eq by p into p by q square. Okay, so what we have is this p and this p cancel out, q square cancel out. So we have d by p plus f into p by q square. Now remember that q square is actually equal to pr because p, q, r are in ap, sorry, gp. So we had q square is equal to pr. So in place of q square, I can write down pr, which is equal to, in here p and p cancel out and 1 q cancel out. So we have 2e divided by q. So we have p and p cancelling out here. So d by p plus f by r is equal to 2e by q, which was required to be proved, to prove that d by p, e by q and f by r are in ap. That's done. Next question. Find all sequences which are simultaneously ap and gp. Okay, now suppose that we start with a GP. So this is a GP, A, AR, AR square, AR cube, and so on and so forth. So we need to find out all those sequences which are both AP and GP. So we have intentionally taken this to be in GP. Now we want this to be in AP as well, because we want it to be both AP. So you could have done it the other way. You could have start with an AP series. So you could have taken your series as A, A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and so on. And then you could have used the fact that it is also in GP and then use the conditions. So it's your discretion to choose the path that you want to take. So what I have done is that I have chosen a GP, and now I want this to be in AP as well. So for this to be in AP, what do I need? So just take suppose the first three terms. So I need first term plus third term is equal to twice of the second term. So that means I need 2AR to be equal to A plus AR square. And let's see, what do we get? So A and A cancel out. So I have 2R is equal to 1 plus R square. So we have 1 plus R square minus 2R is equal to 0. This gives us R minus 1 the whole squared is equal to 0. And this gives us R is equal to 1. So what we have our sequence to be equal to A, then A, then A, because R is actually 1. So A into 1 is 1, A into 1 square, sorry, A into 1 is A, then A into 1 square is A into 1 cube is A. So all of these terms are actually A and A, and that means that this is a constant sequence. So that means a constant sequence is both in AP as well as in GP, because in that case the common ratio is 1 and the common difference becomes 0. So for AP, our common difference becomes A minus A, which is 0. So a constant sequence is the only sequence which is in AP as well as in GP. And if we consider it to be an AP, the common difference is 0. And if we consider this to be a GP, the common ratio is equal to 1. Okay, next question. If A, B and C, so that's done. So those two questions were actually missing from the first video. So the voice was missing from those two questions. And now this third question is actually from the start of this second video. So now on, I'll be giving you all those new questions, and we'll then be taking the concept of the sum up to n terms of a GP in this video as well. Okay, so if A, B and C are in GP, prove that log A, log B and log C are in AP. So what we are given? We are given that A, B, C are in GP. So what do we need? So that means B square is equal to AC is given, because A, B, C are in GP. So second term square is equal to first term into third term. Now take log on both the sides. So taking log on both the sides, I get log B square is equal to log AC. Now applying some properties of log, I get 2 comes outside, so 2 times log B is equal to log A plus log C. And this is actually what is the definition of NAP. So this plus this is equal to 2 times of this. That means if you consider this to be the second term and these two as the first and the third term of the AP, then I'm getting that twice of the second term is actually equal to first and the first plus the third term. So this means that log A, log B and log C, log A, log B and log C are in AP, and hence we are done. That's it. Okay, the sum of first three terms of a GP is 13 by 12 and their product is minus 1. So let's take the first three, so let's take the GP to be A by R, A and AR as discussed in the previous videos. So we are given that the sum of these three terms is 13 by 12. So that means A by R plus A plus AR is equal to 13 by 12. So we can take A common and R as LCM. So we'll be getting 1 plus R squared is equal to 13 by 12. And we are given that their product is minus 1. So what we have A by R times A times AR is equal to minus 1. That means we have R and R cancelling out. So we have A cube is equal to minus 1. So we have A is equal to cube root of minus 1, which is minus 1. That's the only possibility. So we have the value of A. All we need to do is just put it over here. So what we have, 1 plus R square divided by R. And I can take this minus 1 on the other side. So I get minus 13 by 12. And then I can cross multiply and simplify. See what do we get. 12 plus 12R plus 12R square is equal to minus 13R. And I take this minus 13R on the other side and see what do we get. So 12R square plus 25R plus 1, sorry, plus 12 is equal to 0. So now applying Sridharacharya, I get R is equal to minus 25 plus or minus root over 25 square, which is 625 minus 4 into 12 whole divided by 2 times 12, which is 24. So I'm sorry for being out of space here. So please adjust. So R is equal to minus 25 plus or minus root over, on simplification, what do I get? 12 times 12 is 144. 144 times 4 gives me 4 4s are 16. 4 16 17. 5 76. 625 minus 576 gives me 9. And then 8 12 minus 8 49. So I get 49 divided by 24. So this gives me minus 25 plus or minus 7 divided by 24. So if I take plus, then I get R is equal to minus 25 plus 7. So minus 25 plus 7 gives me minus 18 divided. Sorry, it was my phone. So minus 25 plus 7 gives us minus 18, isn't it? Yeah, so minus 18 by 24. And if I take minus, then minus 25 minus 7 gives me minus 32 by 24. So if I cancel it out with 3, so 3 6 are 18, 3 4, sorry, 3 8s are 24. And again with 2, so 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. So I get one value of R. Okay, let me erase some part. So we have, we can cancel it out with 6, 6 threes are 18, 6 fours are 24, and this with 8. This is 8 fours are 32, 8 threes are 24. So our two values of r are minus 3 by 4 and minus 4 by 3, and the value of a that we got was equal to minus 1. So our initial numbers that we took were a by r, a, and ar. So taking r is equal to minus 3 by 4, my numbers become 3 by 4, minus 3 by 4, and again 3 by 4. And if I take r is equal to minus 4 by 3, then my numbers become 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3, and 4 by 3. So these are the three numbers, and of course the they are in GP, and the product is minus 1, and they all satisfy, I guess, that their sum is 13 by 12. So you can check it out. Okay, now the sum up to n terms of a GP. Okay, so let's start with a GP, which is of the form A, AR, AR square, all the way up to A r to the power of n minus 1. Remember that the last term or the nth term of the GP was A into r to the power of n minus 1. Now what do we want? We want to sum up this GP. So we want to have the sum of all these numbers. That means the sum of the GP up to the nth term. So what do we have? We have this. Now we need to find out the value of this sum. That means we need to have a formula for this. So what I do, I multiply with r in each of these terms. So what I have on the left hand side, s times r, and on the right hand side I have, in here I multiply with r, so I get ar. So I write it down over here, plus if I multiply r over here, I get ar square, then I get ar cube, all the way up to the last second term is actually a r to the power of n minus 2, and when I multiply r, I get a r to the power of n minus 1, and this is the last term, and when I multiply r over here, then I get a r to the power of n. So this is actually the sum. All right, now I can subtract all of these terms. So what do I get? I get s minus sr on the left hand side, a, so here I have nothing, so let's assume here is 0. So a minus 0 is a, ar and ar cancel out, ar square cancel out, all these terms cancel out, and I am just left with the last term. So minus a r to the power of n. Now what I can do is take s common over here, so I have s into 1 minus r, and then I can take a common over here, so I have 1 minus r to the power of n. So the value of s, which was the required sum because we had to find out the value of this sum, so s is equal to a times 1 minus r to the power of n divided by 1 minus r. So this is the formula for the sum up to n terms of a GP. So remember that in order to apply this formula, you have to make sure that r is not equal to 1, because in that case the denominator becomes 0. So in that case we cannot apply that formula. So in all other cases, when you have r to be greater than 1 or less than 1, you can still apply this formula and you'll be getting the sum. So no problem in that. But what if r is equal to 1? So let's take that. So if again I consider my GP to be this AR, and then AR square, and so on up to AR to the power of n minus 1. And what if R is equal to 1 in that case? So we already know that in that case my GP will actually be a constant sequence. So we'll be having A all the way up to how many times? N times, right? So in that case my sum will be A plus A plus A N times. So in that case the sum will be equal to NA. And that's it. We don't have R because we already know the value of R. R is equal to 1. So when R is equal to actually 1, then the sum is NA. So S is equal to NA when R is equal to 1. And when R not equal to 1, then we have the sum to be equal to A times 1 minus R to the power of N by 1 minus R. So remember this thing. This is the formula. Okay, let's take up some problems in this. Find the sum of 8 terms of the GP 3, 6, 12, 24. So what is my A here? My A here is 3. What is my R? R is 6 divided by 3, which is equal to 2. So I need to find out the sum up to 8 terms. So S8 is equal to, let me write down the formula first. Okay, Sn is actually equal to A into 1 minus R to the power of N by 1 minus R. This is the sum of the first N terms. So we need to find out S8. All I need to do is put down 8 in place of N. So A is equal to 3, 1 minus 2 to the power of 8 divided by 1 minus 2. So I get 3 times 1 minus 2 to the power of 8 by minus 1. I can adjust this minus 1 with the above. So I can write down as 2 to the power of 8 minus 1 by 1. And because denominator 1 in the denominator doesn't give us any fruit, so I just remove it from there. And now you can simplify it to get the answer. So 2 to the power of 8 is, you do it in the calculator, I think 576 maybe. So whatever it is, you find out the value and write down your final answer. Next, find the sum of the series 2 plus 6 plus 18 plus 54 all the way up to 4374. So first of all, we have to find out how many terms are actually there in this GP. So we know that nth term is 4374. And the formula for the nth term is A times R to the power of N minus 1 is 4, 3, 7, 4. What is A? A is 2 over here. What is R? R is 6 divided by 2, which is actually 3. So 3 to the power of N minus 1 is 4, 3, 7, 4. So 3 to the power of N minus 1 is 4, 3, 7, 4 divided by 2, which is 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 17, 2 8s are 16. 14, 2 sevens are 14. Okay, now 1187 we have to write it as a power of 3. So 1187 I can factorize 3, 3s are 9, 28, 28, so 3 9s are 27. Did I do some mistake? Do this. Yeah, I think I did. So this is 2187. And not 1187, so it's 2187. And now we need to factorize 2187. So 3 7s are 21, 3 2s are 6, 27, 3 9s are 27, 3 2s are 6, 12, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 21, 3 7s are 21, then 3 9s are 27. Then 3 3s are 3 and 1. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 many 3s. So I can write down 2187 as 3 to the power of 7. And then I get n minus 1, this power to be equal to this power. So n minus 1 is equal to 7. So I have n is equal to 8. So I have found out how many terms are there. So actually there are 8 terms in this series. And then I need to find out S8, which is A times 1 minus R to the power of N by 1 minus R, which is A times, so A is actually 2, 1 minus R is 6 by 2, 3 to the power of 8 by 1 minus 3. So I have 2, 1 minus 3 to the power of 8 by minus 2. 2 and 2 cancel out, and I can adjust this minus with the above. So 3 to the power of 8 minus 1 is my answer. So this is the sum of the above GP. Next question. Sum of 5 plus 55 plus 555 up to n terms. So remember that there is a particular trick to do such kinds of questions. So let's start with what is given. 5 plus 55 plus 555 all the way up to n terms. Okay. So it doesn't matter whether it is 5 plus 55 plus 555 or it is 7 plus 77 plus 777. The trick here is that in here you take 5 common. So you'll be having 1 plus 11 plus 111 all the way up to n terms. So suppose that instead of 5 plus 55 plus 5, 5, 5, you are having 7 plus 77 plus 7, 7, 7. Then what you need to do is just take 7 common. If you are having 3 plus 33 plus 3, 3, 3, then you need to take 3 common and make all of the others as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, like this. So now what we need to do is you can write this, you take 1 by 9 common. So what in that case we get 9 plus 99 plus 999 all the way up to n terms. So always we have to make it 9 plus 99 plus 999. So in the next step you always have to take this 1 by 9 outside and make all of these terms as 99999, and then this is the adjustment that actually you need to remember. And then what do we need is to write this 9 as 10 minus 1, this 99 as 10 square minus 1, because 10 square is 100, 100 minus 1 is 99. Then this 999 as 10 cube minus 1. So that is why we always need to make this as 999 for this adjustment to happen. And this up to n terms. Now if you see, if you separate this 10, 10 square, 10 cube all in one place and minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 on the other bracket, then you get a GP. So what do we get? 5 by 9, then 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube all the way up to n terms. And minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 n times separately. Okay, so now this thing is a GP with common ratio equal to 10, because constantly 10 is being multiplied to the preceding number. So I'll just write down this now. So what is the sum of this? So the sum is A, which is 10, 1 minus r to the power of n, or I can write down the formula as r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. So this will be helpful because I won't be getting negative in the denominator. So whenever I see that r is something positive, initially itself you multiply the numerator and the denominator in the formula with a minus 1. So just to clarify more, the formula that we have learnt is this. So if you multiply minus 1 on both the numerator and denominator, you get this. So r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. So this will give you a positive denominator from the very beginning. So we don't need to cancel out with the negative that we get in the denominator every time, like we did in the previous two examples. So this is the formula. A is 10, r is also 10. So I'll be getting 10 to the power of n minus 1 by 10 minus 1. So that means 10 by 9. Times 10 to the power of n minus 1. So I can write, in place of this entire sum, I can write down this value. So what is minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 n times? It is minus n, because suppose we have minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 3 times, what do you have? Minus 3. What do you have? Minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 5 times, you have minus 5. So you have minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, n times, you'll be getting minus n, as simple as that. So I'll just erase all of these. So you please make a note of all these. And I'll write down, get 5 by 9. Then the first sum was actually equal to 10 by 9, 10 to the power of n minus 1 and minus n. So we can also simplify 50 by 81. 10 to the power of n minus 1 minus 5n by 9. This is the sum up to n terms. So let's just verify whether we are getting the correct answer or not. So if you suppose you take n is equal to 2, that means you want to have these two terms only. So what do we get if you put n is equal to 2? If you get n is equal to 2 over here, then what do you get? 50 by 81 times 10 square minus 1 minus 5 into 2 by 9. So 10 square minus 1 is 100 minus 1, which is 99. So in place of this, I can write down 99, and I can cancel out with 9, so I get 11, 9, so I get 550 by 9 minus 5 twos are 10 by 9. So what I get? 550 minus 10, 540 by 9, which gives me 60. So see, the first two terms are actually summing up to 60. And from this formula as well, I am getting the value to be 60. You can also try it for n equal to 3, 4, 5, whatever you like, and you will see that it's actually coming out to be true. Next question. The sum of first three terms of a GP is 16, and the sum of its next three terms is 128. Find the sum of n terms of the GP. Okay, so the first three terms of the GP are A, AR, and AR square, and the next three terms are AR cube, AR to the power of 4, and AR to the power of 5. The question says that the sum of the first three terms is 16, so that means the sum of these three terms is 16. And the sum of the next three terms is 128. That means the sum of these three terms is 128. All I need to do is just find out the values of A and R, and then I'm done. So what I have A plus AR square is equal to 16. And I have AR cube plus AR to the power of 4 plus AR to the power of 5 is equal to 128. What I can do is take A common over here. 1 plus R square is equal to 16, and I can take AR cube common over here. So I have 1 plus R square is equal to 128. So if I divide this equation with this equation, what do I get? A 1 plus R square divided by 16. So this entire term cancels out, and A and A cancel out. I have R cube is equal to 128 by 16. I have calculator in my hand. 128 by 16 is equal to 8. So R cube is equal to 8. That means R is equal to 2. So we have got the value of R, and I just need to put down the value of R over here to get the value of A. So I get A 1 plus 2 plus 2 square is equal to 16. So I have A 1 plus 2 plus 4 is equal to 16. So I have 4 plus 2, 6, 7. A into 7 is equal to 16. So A is equal to 16 by 7. Okay. So I have got the value of A to be 16 by 7, and R is equal to 2. And then I need to find out the sum of n terms. That means I just need to write down the formula. So Sn is equal to A into R to the power of n minus 1 by R minus 1. So A was 16 by 7. R was actually 2 to the power of n minus 1 by 2 minus 1. So 16 by 7 times 2 to the power of n minus 1 divided by 1. So I'm omitting it because 1 in the denominator is of no use. That's it. This is the answer. Next, in an increasing GP, the sum of the first and the last terms is 66. The product of the second and the last but one means the second last term. So the product of second and the second last term is 128, and the sum of the terms is 126. How many terms are there in the GP? Okay, so assume that my GP is again AR square all the way up to AR to the power of n minus 1. This is my last term. So the question says that the sum of the first and the last term is 66. That means the first term plus the last term is 66. Then this question says that the product of the second and the last second term will be AR to the power of n minus 2. So this will be my second last term. So the product of second, which is AR, so AR times last second term is AR to the power of n minus 2 is 128. So let's first of all use these two equations only, and then we'll be taking up the third condition that the sum of all the terms is 126. We'll take it up later. Let's see what do we get from these two equations itself. So from the second equation, I can write it down as A square into R to the power of n minus 2 plus 1 is equal to 128. A square R to the power of n minus 1 is equal to 128. And I can write this as A times A into R to the power of, so this is product, R to the power of n minus 1 is equal to 128. So this is actually the last term, remember? So I can get the value of A R to the power of n minus 1 as 128 by A. So I can put it down in this first equation. And what do I get? I get A plus 128 by A is equal to 66. So let me take A LCM. So I get A square plus 128 minus 66A is equal to 0. So I can apply Sridharacharya formula. A, let me first write it down in this form. A square minus 66A plus 128 is equal to 0. And now I can apply Sridharacharya. A is equal to minus B plus minus root over B square minus 4 into A into C whole divided by 2A. So what do I get inside the square root? I have the calculator in my hand. So 66 square minus 4 times 128 gives me 3844. So I have 66 plus minus root over 3844 divided by 2. And what is the square root of 3844? 3844, the square root of 3844 is 62. So I have 66 plus minus 62 by 2. So if I take the positive sign, so I get A is equal to 66 plus 62 divided by 2 gives me 64. And if I take the minus sign, so I get 66 minus 66, 62, so 4 by 2, so I get 2. So I get the two values of A to be equal to 64 and 2. All right. So using this, what I can do, can I find out R as well? No, not that easy. But surely I can use it over here to get some simpler equation in the form of R and N. So let's do that. Let me erase some part. So these are the two values of A that I've got. And this was the equation that we had got initially. So what I can do, I can put on the value of A is equal to 64 in here. So see, what do I get? R to the power of n minus 1 is equal to 128 by A square, which is 128 by 64 square. So what do I get? 128 by 64 square is gonna be too small a number. So 128 divided by 64 square is 1 by 32. So it's turning out to be 1 by 32, but r to the power of n minus 1, this is less than 1. This cannot happen because we are given in question that this is an increasing GP. An increasing GP means that the numbers continuously go on increasing. That means the value of the constant ratio has to be greater than 1. So suppose that you are constantly multiplying the numbers with 2, 3 or 4, then only your GP will increase. But if you multiply with something less than 1, suppose you multiply with half or one third, then your GP is going to decrease. So we cannot have this r to the power of n minus 1 to be equal to 1 by 32 because in that case our GP will be decreasing. So this is not possible. So A is equal to 64 cannot happen. So what I have, A is equal to 2, and let's see what do I get on putting this. So I have 128 by A square is equal to 128 by 2 square. And what do we have? 128 by 4 is equal to 32, right? So I have r to the power of n minus 1 is equal to 32. So this will be useful after some time. Let's see. Now this third equation is left. The sum of the terms is 126. So I have Sn is equal to 126. And the formula for Sn is A into r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1 is equal to 126. So I need to use r to the power of n minus 1 equal to 32. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's multiply on both the sides with r. So if I multiply both sides with r, I get r to the power of n is equal to 32r. So I have r to the power of n equal to 32r, and A is already known to me, A is equal to 2. So 2, r to the power of n is 32r minus 1 by r minus 1 is equal to 126. 2 and 126 cancels out to give 63. And 32r minus 1 is equal to 63r minus 63. and 32 on the other side. So 63R minus 32R gives me 63 minus 32, 31R. And 63 on this side gives me 63 plus minus 1 to be equal to 62. So R is equal to 62 by 31, which is actually equal to 2. So I'm getting the value of R is equal to 2. So the value of R is now known to me, and we already know that R to the power of n minus 1 was 32. So R power n minus 1 was equal to 32. R is 2 to the power of n minus 1. 32 can be written as 2 to the power of 5. So I have n minus 1 is equal to 5. This gives me n is equal to 6. So how many terms are there in this GP? All we needed to do was to just find out the value of n. So this is nothing but just some equations, and you need to solve them simultaneously. All you need to do is write down the facts of the equation, write down all those formula that you know, and then form some equations, and then you just need to have your equation solving skills at hand, and that's it. Next question. Find the sum of the n terms of the sequence given by an is equal to 3 to the power of n plus 5n. So we need to find out the sum up to n terms. So that means, okay, what is the first term? 3 to the power of 1 plus 5 into 1. So this is the first term. What is the second term? 3 to the power of 2 plus 5 into 2. This is the second term. What is the third term? 3 to the power of 3 plus 5 into 3. All I am doing is just putting 1, 2, and 3 constant continuously in place of n. That will give me the first, second, and third terms respectively. And all the way up to nth term is nothing but the same thing. 3 to the power of n plus 5n. This is the nth term. And now I need to find out the sum. So what I do, I take these first terms together and the second terms together. So I have 3 to the power of 1 plus 3 to the power of 2 plus 3 to the power of 3 all the way up to 3 to the power of n plus 5 into 1 plus 5 into 2 plus 5 into 3 all the way up to 5 into n. Now this is in GP with the first term as equal to 3 to the power of 1 and common ratio as 3, because continuously we are multiplying 3 to the previous number. So the sum of this is actually equal to A times R to the power of n, because there are n terms from 1, 2, 3 up to n. So there are n terms. 3 to the power of n minus 1 by 3 minus 1 plus, I can take 5 common in the second bracket. So I get 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way up to n. So this is an AP, and we have already discussed in the previous video, the value of this sum is n into n plus 1 by 2. Okay, if you don't remember, let me derive it again. So what do we do? This is an AP because the first term is A and the common difference is 1. We are constantly adding 1 to the previous term. So the sum of this is 2A, that means 2 times 1, plus n minus 1 times D, which was 1. So this is the AP, and we have to divide by n by 2, remember? So n by 2 we have to divide. So the sum turns out to be n by 2, 2 plus n minus 1, which gives me n by 2, n plus 1. So this is the sum of this. So if you want to do it even better, just remember that this 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is actually an AP. The first term is A and the common difference is 1. You already know the formula for the n sum of the n terms of an AP. In terms of A, D, and N, just put down those values. A is 1, D is also 1, and N you keep it as N only. And you simplify yourself, use it on pen and paper, and you will see that it turns out to be this. Okay, so 3 by 2, 3 to the power of N minus 1 plus 5 times N by 2 into N plus 1. That's it, this is my answer to the question. This is the sum of the n terms of the given expression. Next, if S1, S2, and S3 be respectively the sum of n, 2n, and 3n terms of a GP, then prove that this holds. Okay, no problem. So we have S1 to be equal to the sum of n terms. What is the sum of two n terms? A times R to the power of n minus 1 by R minus 1. What is S2? S2 is the sum up to 2n terms. So S2 is a r to the power of 2n minus 1 by r minus 1. And what is S3? S3 is a times r to the power of 3n minus 1 by r minus 1. Alright, so now we need to prove that this thing holds. So no problem, let's just start with the left hand side first. So what is left hand side? S1 times S3 minus S2. What is S1? S1 is a times r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1 multiplied by what is S3? A time sorry yeah a times r to the power of 3n minus 1, sorry, it's not minus 1 over here, and then r minus 1 minus S2. S2 is a r to the power of 2n minus 1 by r minus 1. So we need to simplify this. So I get a r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. Then I can take a common in these two. So I get a, third bracket open, r to the power of 3n minus 1 by r minus 1 minus r to the power of 2n minus 1 by r minus 1. Okay, now I can multiply a and a to give me a square r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1, and then r minus 1 I can take as LCM, and in the numerator I am left with r to the power of 3n minus r to the power of 2n. Minus 1 and plus 1 will cancel out, and this becomes a square by r minus 1 the whole squared times r to the power of n minus 1 and r to the power of 3n minus r to the power of 2n. I can take r to the power of 2n common. So r to the power of 2n, if I take common r to the power of 2n, I get n over here and 1 over here. So this r to the power of n minus 1. So r to the power of n minus 1 into r to the power of n minus 1 gives me r to the power of n minus 1 whole square. So a square r minus 1 the whole squared. Then r to the power of n minus 1 the whole squared and r to the power of 2n. Now this entire thing is actually a whole square. So let me make up some space over here. So I can write this thing as a by r minus 1 r to the power of n minus 1 into r to the power of n, this entire thing the whole squared, and this we'll have to simplify, and I think this will come out to be S2 minus S1 because this is what we needed to prove in the right hand side. So let's see what S2 minus S1 gives us. So if S2 minus S1, I can get a r to the power of 2n minus 1 by r minus 1 minus a r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. I can take a by r minus 1 common, and I get r to the power of 2n minus r to the power of n, and I can take r to the power of n common, so I get a r minus 1 r to the power of n r to the power of n minus 1. So this is actually this entire thing, this is S2 minus S1. So we are actually done. This is the right hand side, and we have proved the result. Next question: if S be the sum, P be the product, and R be the sum of reciprocals of n terms in a GP, prove that P square is S by R. No problem. So what is S? S is the sum of n terms. So S is equal to a r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. P is the product, so P is a times AR times AR square, sorry, all the way up to AR to the power of n minus 1. So we can simplify this. A times A times A will give me A to the power of n because n terms are there. There's the first term, second term, third term. This is the nth term. So we are having a n times. So that is why a to the power of n, and it's not a to the power of n minus 1, okay, because there are n times, n terms in this entire expression. Then we have r to the power of 0, this is plus 1 plus 2 all the way up to n minus 1. So I get a to the power of n, and what is the power? So the power is 1 plus 2 plus all the way up to n minus 1. So this is an AP, the first term is 1, and there are n minus 1 terms, because 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1 is actually n minus 1 terms. So the formula will be n minus 1 by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So I have n minus 1 by 2, 2 plus n minus 2 gives me n times n minus 1 by 2. So this is the sum. So I get r to the power of n into n minus 2 by 2. Okay, so this is the value of p. And what is r? R is the sum of reciprocals. So r is 1 by a plus 1 by ar plus all the way up to 1 by a r to the power of n minus 1. So what we can do is just take 1 by a r to the power of n minus 1. So I have r to the power of n minus 1 plus r to the power of n minus 2, okay, plus r to the power of n minus 3 all the way up to 1. Now this thing is in GP, and constantly r is being multiplied. So if you think it in the reverse order, like 1 plus r square all the way up to r to the power of n minus 1, then this is a GP with n many terms, because the initially the power of r is 0, so it starts from 0, 1, 2 and all the way up to n minus 1, so there are n terms, and constantly r is being multiplied. So you think of it in the reverse order, from 1 to the other way, it will be helpful for you. You can also think of it in the same order, but in that case the common ratio will be 1 by r. But if you think in the reverse order, from 1 to the end, the common ratio will be r. So it's 1 by a r to the power of n minus 1. Then what is the first term? First term is a for our case, so it is 1 into r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. So this is the value of capital R, okay, and all we need to do is just see whether this thing turns out to be true or not. So let me clear some space. So first of all, let's start with RHS. So RHS is S by R whole to the power of N. What is S? A into R to the power of N minus 1 by R minus 1 whole divided by, what is the value of r? It's 1 by a r to the power of n minus 1. So what I can actually do is multiply it with the reciprocal. So I get a into r to the power of n minus 1, and this also will be multiplied by r minus 1 r to the power of n minus 1. So I have just multiplied with the reciprocal, and this whole entire thing raised to the power of n, because we are having s by r whole to the power of n, so we have to raise this thing to the power of n. Okay, r power n minus 1, r power n minus 1 cancel out, r minus 1, r minus 1 cancel out. All I am left with is a square, so a into a is a square, r to the power of n minus 1, this entire thing whole to the power of n. Okay, so this is my right hand side, and what is my p square? So p square is the square of this thing. So p square is a to the power of n r to the power of n into n minus 2 by 2. Was this n minus 2? I think it's n minus 1. I think it was n minus 1. Please do verify. Let me just check. So there are n minus 1. Yeah, it will be n minus 1. I think I did a mistake. So this will be the square of this. So it is a to the power of 2n and r to the power of n into n minus 1. So r n to the power of n minus. So this is actually equal to the RHS itself. 2n r to the power of n into n minus 1. So p square and this thing s by r whole to the power of n are actually turning out to be the same and hence proved. Okay, next, a man has two parents, four great grandparents and eight great grandparents and so on. So think of like you are having two parents, one mother and one father, and four great grandparents. So one set of grandparents on your mother's side and one set of grandparents on your father's side. So having four grandparents, eight great grandparents. So it will go on like your grandfather will have mama papa, your grandmother will have mama papa. So this is for your suppose father's side, and then again for your mother's side you'll be having four more, so eight in all. So in how many total ancestors do you have preceding his own? That means you have to find out the total ancestors of the man excepting the man. Preceding his own means that you don't have to include this man. So that means the total number of ancestors will be 2 plus 4 plus 8 all the way up to 10 generations. So what is the 10th generation? I don't know. So just write down 10 terms. So there are 10 terms. And now what is S10? S10 is A. R is 2 because 4 by 2 is 2. So R to the power of N minus 1 by R minus 1, which is 2 by minus 1. So 2 times 2 to the power of N minus 1 by 2 minus 1 is 1. So it is just 2 into 2 to the power of 10 minus 1. This is the total number of ancestors that the man has preceding his own, excluding the man. Okay. Next question. The lengths of three unequal edges of a rectangular solid block are in GP. So the length of three unequal edges. So assume that the three edges B, that means the length, breadth and height. So assume that the length is equal to A by R, breadth is equal to A, and height is equal to AR. So these are in GP. The question says that these are in GP. The volume of the block is 216. So we know that volume is length into breadth into height. So A by R into A into AR is equal to 216. R and R cancels out. A cube is equal to 216. So A is equal to 6 because 216 is actually 6 cube. So A turns out to be 6. And then we have another equation. Total surface area is 252. Total surface area, we know that formula is 2 times LB plus BH plus LH is equal to 252. So LB plus BH plus LH is equal to 252 by 2, which is 2 ones are 2, 2 to the 4, 12, 2 6 are 12. What is, let's write down the values for LB and H. So L is A by R into A plus A into AR plus A by R into AR is equal to 126. So I have A square by R plus A square R plus A square, R and R cancels out, is equal to 126. I can take A square common, 1 by R plus 1 is equal to 126. The value of A is 6, so A square is 36. So I'll put it down on the other side. 1 by R plus 1 is equal to 126 by 36. So 126 by 36, I have calculator. So 34 by 9. So this turns out to be 34 by 9. I can put down 1 on the other side. So 1 by R plus R is equal to 34 by 9 minus 1 gives me 25 by 9. 25 by 9. And then I need to solve it for R. So let me clear everything. 1 by r plus r is equal to 25 by 9. So I have r square plus 1 times 9 is equal to 25r. 9r square minus 25r plus 9 is equal to 0. R is equal to 25 plus minus root over 25 square minus 4 times 9 divided by 2 into 9 is equal to 25 plus minus root over 625 minus 9 9s are 81 times 4 gives me 324 divided by 18. So 25 plus minus root over 625 minus 324 is 301. The root of 301 is not defined. I think I did some mistake in solving the equation. Okay, so you check, the steps are same. I might have messed it in some of the steps, so I don't actually remember. So you please do it yourself. I don't think there'll be a problem, so try it out and let me know in the comment section if you're having some problem. So that's it. And then finally, when you are done with finding the value of r, then find out all those three sides with a by r and a and ar as the three sides, and then just give the longest measurement. Whichever you find to turn out to be the longest, you write down that side, because that is what the question asks. And that's it. Thanks a lot for studying with A-level math. Study hard, study smart, and all the best. Bye-bye.